It's 12 minutes past the hour. Our meteorologist, Matt, has stepped in, and I know what you're saying. You're saying 12 past the hour? Isn't it 8 past the hour when these people are supposed to be here? Well, we're not going to do the weather forecast right now. We're going to learn something about the weather. And isn't that a noble thing?
Learning is always good. It's a lot of fun.
Learning is fun. Mm-hmm. And there's no more fun than learning about the weather. So let's talk about something that isn't part of our weather now, but certainly will become part of our weather in the not-too-distant future, and that is thunderstorms.
Thunderstorms.
Okay. Now, they are... Certainly, I have a dog who is terrified of thunderstorms, and I try to explain that it's nothing to be afraid of. So why don't you explain to me what really are the ingredients that come to make a thunderstorm?
It seems like all dogs seem to be scared of thunderstorms, don't they? Because my dog's terrified of thunderstorms.
And what is it? Have you ever tried to explain it to him?
You know, I try to, but they...
That doesn't seem to...
go and try to hide, or my dog barks at the thunder.
Yes.
It's counterproductive.
We're gonna do our best here to explain it to all the dogs who may be listening.
All the dogs.
What are the ingredients? What are you looking for to know that this might be a day with thunderstorms?
When you're looking for thunderstorms, you usually want to have humid air that's very full, a lot of moisture, and you want to also be able to have an atmosphere that's able to lift that moisture from the ground and into the sky. And when you have lifting, there's a thing that meteorologists call lifted indexes. You want those to be pretty high. That way the air can be lifted, and as the air lifts, it can cool and form clouds.
Now, I've noticed when I look out my window on a day that ultimately has thunderstorms, in many cases, you start to see these puffy clouds form, and then they grow. What allows them to grow so tall? And they seem to grow tall on a thunderstorm day. What's different about the atmosphere that allows tall clouds to grow?
Well, the atmosphere is very unstable.
So am I. But that doesn't tell us anything. What does unstable mean?
Unstable means that the air parcel can actually lift, and as it continues to rise into the air, it forms and condenses, and that's where you can see all those puffy, cotton-like features of a thunderstorm.
Ah, so unstable atmosphere just means that parcels go nuts?
If parcels go nuts, they rise, and they have a little bit of fun.
What's the force that makes them go up? I've often wondered this.
It's the air rising. It's the unstable air, which forces it to go up.
Ah, see that? That just about says it all. Why are they more common in the spring and summer than they are in the fall?
The fall and winter, right now. It's because you have to have warm air. In the winter time, the air is not very warm, so you really have, the air can't really rise as well as that you need.
But in September and into October, we often have warm days, as warm as April and May. But there seem to be fewer thunderstorms in September, October than there are in April, May, even though the temperatures are about the same. And you say the difference is humidity?
Humidity, yes. You have to have a lot of moisture in the air. That way you can have the moisture can rise and it condenses, and that's where you can get your rain from. So you have to have that moisture in order to form thunderstorms.
What makes them severe? Sometimes you hear the bells go
off.
The
severe thunderstorms.
They take over my television set and things scroll across.
There's a bunch of different parameters which that make a thunderstorm severe. Now, there can be hail is one feature of a thunderstorm. And I'm going to talk about a couple of factors, and only one of these actually have to happen in order for a thunderstorm to be severe. First one is hail. Hail is common in some thunderstorms, but in order for the thunderstorm to be severe, the hail has to be a quarter inch in diameter, which is about which is about the size of a quarter. So if you can imagine a quarter size hail, hail falls from a storm, that's classified as severe. Now another factor which can make a thunderstorm severe is wind. When you have wind in excess of 56 miles an hour, that storm is considered severe.
Okay.
And then, of course,
53 not severe.
Yeah, 53 not severe.
Yeah, see, I just don't understand. But continue.
Yes. And then another factor which can make a thunderstorm severe is is a tornado.
That sounds severe to me.
Yes, pretty severe. So very damaging.
That's when you say severe thunderstorm, or we hear severe thunderstorm warning, that's what we're they're saying, that there is a storm that might have one or more of those
things. Yep.
All right. Of course, the most, and the thing that drives the dogs nuts, is I think the thunder.
The thunder.
Right?
Exactly.
What makes the sound of thunder?
The sound of thunder, it actually comes from the lightning.
Okay, so the lightning comes first.
And then you hear the big boom.
Yes.
Now the boom, which is most dogs are afraid of.
And then the dog
the dogs go absolutely
soils
nuts.
Soils the carpet at that point, yeah.
Yes, so lightning is what you need in order to have thunder. Now when lightning strikes, lightning's very hot.
Okay.
And it makes the air expand, and it makes a big boom noise. Now, you usually see lightning before you hear the thunder. That's because light travels faster than the speed of sound. So,
it's happening at about the same time.
It's happening at the same time. If you were on location of
the
lightning.
If you were right where the lightning bolt was.
You'd hear them at the same exact, well, you'd see the lightning and hear the thunder at the exact same time.
And then you'd die.
Well, hopefully you don't die. Have you ever had an encounter with a lightning bolt?
Well, not directly, but I can imagine that it might be dangerous. But in any case, it's the rapid expansion of the air.
Rapid expansion of the air.
Now, why can't you just tell the dog that and say, it's just the air expanding?
Yeah.
They don't understand
it. They don't understand it. You know, all they care about is their ears. So if they hear a big loud noise, they...
And their doggy kind of biscuits. Okay, I think we've learned a little bit about thunderstorms, which are still a couple of months away, but now we have at least something that we can try to quiet the animals with.
Yeah, try to quiet those animals.
All right, thank you very much.
Yep.